Johnson, first he started off as a painter, then later on in life, Johnson became a sculptor. Most of Johnson's work has been showed off around the world, for instance, in the United States, Europe, Asia, and etc. Johnson was born in New Jersey in 1930. Currently, Seward is at the age of 85. Johnson is also known for creating life-size sculptures of real-life individuals.
Johnson was inspired by a famous photographer, Bernard of Hollywood, and again he started off as a painter, then into sculpture, and transformation of admiration caused him to create many sculptures like Forever
Marilyn.
Johnson also had passion for detail and realism to create three-dimensional art sculptures.
Forever Marilyn was a sculpture taken from the film The 7-Year Itch, designed on the year 2011 in first place in Chicago at first, then was transferred to California, Palm Springs, then again transferred to New Jersey,
Mercer County.
And the statue of Marilyn Monroe is still standing till this day. The sculpture is 26 foot tall and made out of painted steel and aluminum. The colors used on the sculpture is an off-white to paint the dress and the heels to match, a skin tone beige for the skin. Also, color was added to the hair to make it look blonde, and the red for the red lips and painted toes, and the silver to make her earrings pop out in a real-life form.
The Awakening sculpture is also known as the Buried Giant. Was located in Washington. The sculpture is 70 foot tall, embedded in the ground. Makeshift memorial is placed in Hamilton, New Jersey grounds. Whispering Clothes is also a sculpture of a woman in a gown and a man in a tuxedo dancing like if they were at a ball. According to some of the crowds, they saw the sculpture as revealing too much. For example, the dress flying out from behind, revealing Monroe's panties. It was viewed sexist as well, as the other side of the
viewed the sculpture as family, especially when the sculpture was in California. They loved the sculpture there. And as for Chicago, they loved her there too, but it was
more admired in California. Johnson was inspired
by a famous photographer. That's why he created her.
He is also known to create life-size sculptures that are huge, like The Awakening
and the makeshift memorial.
The sculpture has been graffitied on, destroying the paint and the appearance of the sculpture. Also, the sculpture has been stepped on, giving off a bad image, disrespecting the sculpture. Mainly in Chicago, she has not been respected and caused vandalism to be seen and done on Forever
Marilyn. Also, the sculpture was ranked by virtualtourist.com as the worst piece of art and ranked number one on how the sculpture was placed in Chicago, and that it being placed in Chicago was the worst. John donated the sculpture to travel around and to leave Chicago because of the vandalism and the bad outcome his sculpture was receiving, although it was loved in Chicago, but mainly by tourists that were visiting Chicago.
Andy from England, what do you think of Marilyn?
Very nice, very sexy as always.
Well, yesterday she had a bag on her head. Yeah. It was so much better.
Yeah. Awesome.
We love Marilyn.
Love her. Iconic.
All right, where are you from?
Iowa.
All right. Well, thank you so very much for talking with us today. Hi, would you like to give your impressions for YouTube?
Sure. I think it's great. She's iconic. It's a beautiful statue. It's fun. And it makes you think of this windy city. And here we are. It's
great. Are you visiting from out of town?
Yes, I'm from Denver, Colorado.
Oh, wonderful. So how does it look from this angle?
Looks pretty good.
Quite revealing.
It's Maryland. I mean, it's amazing.
Where are you guys from?
San Francisco.
Wonderful, wonderful. What do you think of Maryland?
I think her legs are a little out of proportion. Looks like a man knee, that right knee.
This morning, a giant statue of Marilyn Monroe is taking shape. We first saw it standing tall nearly a year ago in Chicago.
As Dean Reynolds reports, many people there are sorry to see Marilyn go.
Month after month, they came to stand between her legs and stare.
Once you saw that it was here, what was the impulse?
I had to get under her skirt, you know.
Marilyn Monroe, 26 feet and 40,000 pounds of her, was on display in all her glory for 10 months in Chicago. The sculpture sought to recapture the memorable moment from the film, The 7-Year Itch.
Ooh, do you feel the breeze from the subway? Isn't it delicious?
Critics called it inappropriate kitsch, but the pilgrims who came to Pioneer Court were having none of it.
Girls like her talent and men like her body. Simple as that.
Pasha Vorontsov came all the way from Russia.
Would this work in Moscow?
Definitely, definitely, for sure. Many people will be interested in that.
Might warm up the winters a little bit.
Yeah, oh my gosh, I'm dreaming about it every winter.
On her last day in Chicago, most of those paying homage hadn't been born when Marilyn was alive. Her death will be 50 years ago this August, but some remember her alive and in the flesh, as it were.
For men of a certain age, this is really a dream come true.
The giant Marilyn is the work of sculptor Seward Johnson.
I can't allow myself to do something that I'm not going to like.
Sure.
And I'm just taking a chance. But when I saw it, I fell in love.
You think that pose just sort of captures her?
I think it is the pose that captures her.
He's well aware of the controversy his work generated.
I'd hope not to start fist fights, but I don't mind a little bit of a disagreement is very good because it makes people go down inside themselves to find out what's making them tick.
Last week in the dark of night, Marilyn was disassembled. Her run here had come to an end.
It's a sad day, it really is.
This week, Marilyn made its way to Palm Springs, California, beating out other towns who wanted to host it, because it was in Palm Springs that the real Marilyn burst on the American scene in a series of photos shot locally. On Monday, the leggy foundation and billowing skirt were set in place, followed by the torso and head on Tuesday. The reception was as warm as the desert air.
I love that this statue, this sculpture, is larger than life because Marilyn herself was larger than life. So I think this really epitomizes what she was all about.
We are very excited. Being a business owner downtown, it's going to bring lots of business down here.
It turns out that Marilyn Monroe is still quite a draw. For CBS This Morning, I'm Dean Reynolds in Chicago.
It is amazing where she stands in the cultural galaxy.
And that so many people are still so fascinated by her. We actually have a look for you this morning from Palm Springs. There we have it, a live look. Marilyn against the backdrop of the night. Very early morning in Palm Springs right now. This is what she looks like this morning. There's going to be an official official unveiling later this month. But sounds like from everybody that Dean talked to, they're pretty happy she's there.
Brings warmth.
Yes.
Can't believe it's not butter.